You can find more episodes of Your Thoughts Podcast at yourthoughts.com. We are on Spotify, Apple. Support our Patreon. You can support all sorts of different content through Aggregate Perspective. I do music, the podcast, all different kinds of art. So support the Patreon. That will directly support the podcast. Editing costs cost a lot. So please help out. Like us on Facebook, on Twitter, Your Thoughts Pod. I have an Instagram. It's iPods Are Gross. I don't post as much there, but I do occasionally post podcast related content there. Thank you for watching. Last question, I suppose. We are at an hour, so...
Yeah, so we got to start wrapping up here.
Yeah. I'm not sure how we're doing on batteries.
One of the cameras is gone.
He's out.
Oh, okay. Fuck. All right, so...
Okay. So, I don't even know if we can do this in a short amount of time, but, like, what is the next step? How do we get to anything like...
How do you start implementing?
Yeah,
absolutely. So what I always tell people to do at home is start a garden. It's really simple. It's really easy and it's fun. Yeah, you have to accept that you're probably not going to be a green thumb your first couple years. You're going to lose a lot of plants, but plant a bunch of different things. Anything that you can find, anything that you can think of. If you don't have a lot of space, like if you live in a city in like a metro area, see if you can put one on the roof of your apartment complex.
Take notes.
See if you can, you know, put one on the roof of your apartment complex, or see if, you know, you can start a community garden within your complex itself. You know, there are lots of empty lots in cities, and it doesn't take but, you know, a phone call to say, hey, I want to, you know, hey, to the city council or whatever, do you mind if I use this quarter acre lot that has a bunch of junk on it? You know, I'll move the rocks, I'll move the beat up car, mm-hmm. so I can plant a couple of trees. And what that does is that starts to build your community. Because there's going to come a year, there's going to come a time where you have a tree or, you know, a pumpkin patch that just explodes. Mm-hmm. And you have more pumpkins or lemons than you could even think of what to do with. And so you knock on your neighbor's door, hey, do you want a pumpkin? And now you started to build that community. You started to take those real steps to show other people that you can put in work, you can put in effort and give to other people and see how your whole community can benefit.
Awesome.
So that's one.
Yeah. Then so that would be at the individual level. And then what we can do as people living in a society that has a government is be way more active. Go out and protest anything and everything that you could possibly want to protest. If you have something that you strongly believe in, go get a piece of cardboard or poster board, get a Sharpie, write it on there, and sit out at a corner and show people that are passing by. You're gonna get people that agree with you.
Politically active.
Absolutely. And yeah, I mean, everything is political when you're talking about society. You know, down to puppies should be free. You know, if you think that everybody should be able to be entitled to a free puppy, if you think that everybody should be entitled to 3 square meals a day, that is unfortunately in this day and age political.
Yeah, that's controversial.
That's not something I view as political. I don't think that it's political that people should be able to live without having to produce something.
I think there's this misunderstanding too. Like, literally everything is influenced by the government in some way, so everything is political in some form.
Exactly. And so, yeah, be politically active, but be politically active in the things that you hold most dear, because that's how you're going to find the people that most align with the things that you're looking for.
Your values and
exactly.
your perspective somewhere to go.
Right, because if you're out there once a month, you know, first weekend of every month, holding out that sign, eventually somebody's going to go, hey, he's out there the first of every month, and I agree with that.
Yeah.
He's going to go out there too. Or they're going to go, why are you out here? What is this all about?
And they might agree.
And exactly. And that's how you get started. And that's, again, how you build communities. That's how you start building what you call a parallel power structure, which is what you need to form a society in a place where it's already being oppressed by, like, the government. So you get to a point where you have all of your neighbors and all of your neighborhoods are all communicating with each other too. And that's essentially an anarchist society right there. The government can pass a new law all they want, but if you and your friends don't want to listen to it, how are they going to stop an entire group of neighborhoods, let alone, you know, just, you know, it's
well, we know how,
right? but it's much harder, right? Yes. And it's infinitely harder the more people that you get. And so as you build and as you grow your community, you grow in power, you grow in strength, and then you talk to your local government and you say, hey, these are the things that I want changed, and then they don't change them, and then you make a bigger stink about it. Or, you know, there's a park that needs some restoration, and so you talk to city council, hey, this needs some restoration, when can we get this done? Oh yeah, we'll work on it. They're inevitably not going to work on it, and you bother them and you pester them, and after a while, you in your community, you probably have somebody that knows how to restore that stuff. So you get those, you as a community get those resources pooled together, and you get that renovated, and then you go back, hopefully with a bunch of people and journalists, and you get them to go up with you, and you go, hey, why didn't you do this thing? You said that you would do this thing. You told me months ago that you would get it handled.
Accountability.
Why didn't you get it handled? Yeah, and
following through.
Yeah, and then they'll tell you, oh, we'll get it handled, and you show them, we already did it.
That is definitely a ridiculous aspect of our press currently. They are not holding anybody accountable. They're just following whatever is going on.
Yeah, and so if you get a camera and you get it on recording and you send that out, and that, it's going to go viral. I mean, everybody loves to see a government official get owned. And so that's going to start showing that official, hey, you either need to own up to what you actually are saying, or I'm just going to keep embarrassing you like this.
So start a garden, be politically active.
Embarrass local government.
Embarrass local government.
Shame them.
Let's say accountability.
Oh yeah, I mean that's fine
that's
too,
a
I
nicer
guess.
Way to put Whatever. It. I guess
we want this to be broad so that
Absolutely.
We can bring more people into the ideas.
Maybe sometimes they need some eggs thrown at them. You know,
they're the figure.
That was a joke. That's under be politically
that was a joke.
Active.
I'm not talking about doing any harm to physical harm to political people. Just
no.
That was a joke. I'm just saying.
Okay, Mr. Federal Agents.
And from my understanding of studying anarchism so far, accountability is baked into it as well. You have to justify why you're doing what you're doing.
Yeah, that's what I said earlier. I touched upon the whole in anarchism, you believe that your rights also hold responsibility.
Yeah.
You know, like your Second Amendment right. You have the right to bear arms. But
so a lot of the people that were tried for crimes and eventually killed, they attempted to justify what they did in court because that was a principle for them.
Mm-hmm. And so,
killdozer.
Know, right. And it's, you know, you, at some point you have to understand that people will take action if they feel as though they're not being heard.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you have that accountability. Like I was saying with the Second Amendment, you have the right to bear arms, but you have the responsibility to do it correctly. You know, if you can own a handgun all you want, but if something were to happen and there's an errant discharge and somebody gets killed, that's on you. That's your gun. That's your responsibility. At the end of the day, no matter how much people want to say that their rights are their rights and there's nothing about it, you do still have that responsibility, even at that fundamental level. You know, even with your First Amendment, not yelling fire in a crowded movie theater, right? And not doing nothing about that is inherently illegal, but you shouldn't do it. That causes chaos. It's going to harm somebody. And so it violates the NAP for anarchists.
Mm-hmm.